All right, welcome back. Helping you live healthy around the holidays. It seems like an oxymoron, right? Well, both binge alcohol consumption, overeating have been linked to something called holiday heart syndrome. It is the seasonal spike in atrial fibrillation observed in otherwise healthy people, and it happens during the holidays. Dr. Saumil Oza, chief cardiologist at St. Vincent's Riverside, joining us now to discuss this phenomena and really show us how to make heart-healthy choices this holiday season. So we talk about, good morning, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Let's dive right in, because I'm already 5 pounds up since Halloween. You know what? I mean, it starts with the chocolate and Halloween, and then it just keeps going through Thanksgiving,
yes,
and then you
does.
Have Christmas, and you just kind of never stop eating. Can you define kind of what that binge eating mm-hmm. and binge drinking is?
So holiday heart is described as binge drinking, actually. That's really what causes it. Drinking more than 3 to 4 glasses of alcohol within 1 to 2 hours,
okay.
That can trigger arrhythmias, specifically atrial fibrillation. That's the most common arrhythmia seen in human beings. That leads to symptoms of heart failure, shortness of breath. The worst symptom is obviously stroke, and that's something that we want to avoid in everybody. It can happen in otherwise healthy people.
What does that feel like to someone who's never had a heart issue?
So patients often describe it to me as a fish flopping around in their chest while they're just sitting still. Other patients don't feel any symptoms, so it's really very difficult to define just by symptoms.
Does it resolve itself quickly, or can it?
It can. Sometimes it can be. It can last weeks. It can lead to heart failure, which is actually a decrease in your heart function, which can be potentially fatal if it lasts long enough. Luckily, it's usually reversible if we can diagnose and treat it in time. The other cause, it's a very common cause of stroke. You have about 5 times the risk of stroke when you have atrial fibrillation. Yeah. So it's very important to diagnose
it. Right. Are some people more predisposed to it versus others that can still drink a lot and not experience
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. There's a mild genetic component to it. Some people can drink a lot and not get atrial fibrillation. Other mm-hmm. people can drink very little. But the main component is lifestyle. So people, yeah. the same risk factors for heart disease, like high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, these are all linked together, and the more of those risk factors you have, the higher your risk for atrial fibrillation.
So if you start to feel those symptoms, you definitely want to contact your doctor.
Absolutely.
All right, so you brought some things to suck the fun out of our holiday.
We did.
But not really, because
we have some good options.
Yeah, replacement. So like eggnog, some people will never drink it until the holidays,
yeah.
but you're saying even then you should bypass
that's,
it.
That's probably not a great option. Mm-hmm. It has a lot of calories, a lot of fat. A better choice is wine. If you're going to have any drinks, a glass or two of wine would be good. It's higher in antioxidants, lower in calories, far lower in calories than eggnog, so that's a better choice.
Okay. Yeah, and that's an easy swap, because usually you'll have one or the other or
Absolutely.
Both at the
yeah.
party.
Yeah.
All right, so some people will like the jellied cranberry
yeah.
sauce. If you make your own, it tastes a lot better, and it's better for you.
Absolutely. A cranberry relish, which doesn't have the sugar and preservatives that jellied cranberry has, I think that would be a much better choice.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to make this on the morning show, by the way, and
oh, that's
talk
great.
About how to do
Good
it.
For you.
Because it
for
does,
you.
It's a lot more tasty. It's
Absolutely.
Tasty.
And, yeah. and cranberries are considered a superfood, again,
yeah.
high in antioxidants and actually very good for you.
There you go. So you're nailing it with the grapes
mm-hmm.
and with the cranberries.
That's right.
in good
that's
shape.
Right.
All right. And oftentimes you just go and you eat appetizers. Meatballs are a favorite for folks, but maybe shrimp. Are on the table
it's,
as well.
It's a little better, yeah. Shrimp is a little high in cholesterol, but it's much better. It has far more omega-3s, which are also good for the heart. There's been studies now that show benefits for stroke reduction and reduction in coronary disease with foods high in omega-3s. Meatballs, beef, it's a red meat, and that's obviously one of the worst foods you can eat.
Mm-hmm.
It's very pro-inflammatory. Pro-oxidative, so you definitely want to avoid those foods.
Right. So just minor changes in your decision
Absolutely.
Making, because it's cumulative. You know, you're doing it all
yeah.
over the next few months, and it certainly can affect you. Let me ask real quick, though, when should you go to the doctor immediately when you get which kind of symptoms?
So any symptoms, again, of palpitations, of fish flopping around in your
yeah,
chest, shortness of breath, fatigue, they can be somewhat vague, so
mm-hmm.
You have to really kind of pay attention. I always encourage my patients to exercise, because then you can catch these symptoms much,
yeah.
much earlier. Because if you can get on a treadmill and do your normal activities,
you're fine.
But if you notice that, you know, I can't quite reach those goals that I normally have, you catch those symptoms a lot earlier.
Yeah, I love that. You do always say that. So if we want to be healthy, we have to make healthy decisions, folks. And even though it's the holidays, don't ignore it. If you've missed any of this information, don't worry. We'll put this interview on our website, newsforjax.com. Certainly, if you want to share it with someone, because it may
Absolutely.
Not affect you, but it may affect someone you love. All this is under the Live Healthy section.